Morning, Tampa Bay. I'm Melissa Mahadeo. We're going to get to all your news of the day in just a moment, but I'm joined by Jason Adams because we are talking snow this morning.
Crazy.
Jason, thanks. A Facebook post warning residents about convicted sex offenders is causing quite the stir online. A sex offender was advertising, you see, to work as a nanny. Sarasota County deputies say Sarah Glacia had an ad on sitter.com to nanny. The website deactivated her account after we contacted them. Glacia tells us she posted that ad in 2013 before her arrest. She also tells us that she betrayed the trust of a child because a violent ex-boyfriend asked her to do it. This morning, the mayor of Davenport is facing charges and jail time for parking in a handicapped spot right outside of City Hall. The city manager says he saw her do it many times, but the mayor is not handicapped. Detectives say she used two handicapped placards belonging to people who are dead. Detectives say Teresa Bradley even altered the expiration date on one of them. Bradley cannot be removed from office, though, unless she is convicted.
More than 50 indoor skydivers from across the country showed off their best stunts right here in Tampa Bay. Check that out.
Yeah.
Wowzers.
It's difficult to do. Now, during the past few days, they have been competing individually as well as in teams, in iFlies, in New Brandon's facility. These skydivers spent time floating through the wind tunnel, facing wind speeds of up to 170 miles per hour. The competitors say indoor skydiving takes a huge amount of body control, mental awareness, and showmanship. A couple of local kids also participated, by the way, including one as young as 8 years old. I've done it. It is extremely difficult to do. Breaking overnight now, a private charter bus overturned on a San Francisco highway, injuring all 30 passengers on board. Four of them were seriously hurt. You see this video. Witnesses say the bus lost control, hit the center divider, and then tipped over. The overturned bus then skidding across the road before finally coming to a stop. Some of those passengers crawling out through escape hatches in the roof or even out of broken windows. Firefighters still had to rescue two people trapped inside. The cause of that crash is under investigation. A driver who ran a stop sign in South Florida is now being blamed for causing a deadly accident at a restaurant. Police say a woman ran a stop sign near Fort Lauderdale and then hit another car. A 79-year-old man driving that car then spun out of control, accidentally hitting the gas and then plowing into a Pollo Tropical. A man and a 7-year-old boy were treated at a hospital for minor injuries, but a woman sitting in a booth became pinned under the car and then later died at the hospital. Get this one, because Tampa ranks pretty high on a new list of hipster cities. Yes, hipster cities. We are in the top 20. The moving company MoveHub created a hipster index to rank cities based on factors that appeal to young people. It measures things like tattoo parlor density, vegan food availability, and the number of microbreweries and thrift stores in a city. Tampa ranks 17th in the country, partially thanks to the trendy neighborhoods like Ybor. Orlando, by the way, is 11th. Let's get a check of that weather now with Jason Adams in the Weather Center. And yes, my eyes do not deceive me. That is snow on a palm tree. 81 to 50. Talk about a change. All right, Jason, thank you. Thieves caught on camera stealing from a Bradenton Animal Hospital. Authorities are now looking for the truck caught on surveillance video driving away on Tuesday night with a freezer in it. But it's what's inside that freezer that has some pet owners heartbroken. The remains of two dogs that were supposed to be cremated are inside that freezer. The Kahn family in Sarasota paid for their 13-year-old husky to be cremated and have her ashes returned to them. Vet staff searched the neighborhood hoping the thief threw out those two plastic bags clearly labeled animal remains. Police say they are looking for a dark, medium-sized pickup truck, possibly a Nissan Frontier. Tell me if this sounds familiar. You get in your car and then you get stuck every morning in bumper-to-bumper traffic trying to get from Big Bend Road to I-75. You're not alone. Drivers call it a nightmare and now they want something done about it fast. That is why one man started a change.org petition. He would like to see more lanes getting on and off of 75. Hillsborough County Public Works is working with FDOT to fund several projects in that area, including widening Big Bend Road. But the bad news is construction won't start for 3 years. Pinellas County deputies want you to see these surveillance images of a violent Pinellas Park robbery. They hope a new angle will help them to catch the thief. Detectives believe he's behind at least 6 armed robberies at convenience stores in a 10-day span. They say he usually carries a knife, but in one case he used a gun. This is video from earlier this week showing him leaping across the counter. Deputies think he might have gotten away in a dark-colored sedan.